A report from U.S. tech firm Simularity shows possible construction on the Mischief Reef in the West Philippine Sea. In its latest South China Sea Rapid Alert report, the firm showed seven sites that appear to have changed from May of last year to February 4, 2021, based on satellite imagery. Mischief Reef is occupied by the Chinese. One of the sites, which appeared to be vacant last year, now appears to have a cylindrical structure. Mischief Reef is the largest among the seven artificial islands in the Spratlys. It lies within the exclusive economic zone of the Philippines. In 2016, the Permanent Court of Arbitration ruled Mischief Reef is part of the Philippine continental shelf. As we just said, Mischief Reef is the biggest island among several man-made ones built by China in the Spratlys. It lies within the 200 nautical mile exclusive economic zone of the Philippines. And in the middle of this raging pandemic, it got even more substantial with more structures being built on it. Joining us now is Dr. J. Batong Bakal. He is the director of the Institute for Maritime Affairs and Law of the Sea at the University of the Philippines. Professor, nice to see you again and welcome to the program.
Hi, good morning, Ravina, and good morning to our viewers.
All right, so while the rest of the world was busy and is still busy battling this pandemic, these images that we've been showing and we're about to show show that China was busy doing other things. What to you is most striking about China's activities on Mischief Reef, Doctor?
Well, of course, number one is the nature of the construction itself. No, they're basically adding on surveillance equipment, apparently radars. There are already a lot of them on the reef in the first place. So the addition of new radar seems to indicate that they're really expanding the capabilities of this artificial island. And then the fact that it is, as you mentioned, continuing despite everything that has been going on in the rest of the world, I think it really indicates the intention of China to really fully develop these artificial islands eventually into full-blown military bases.
Mm. Of course, we can't talk about this without talking about China's relationship with the Philippines. Is this something that can be seen separate and distinct from the close ties the Philippines has with China, which recently led to the vaccine donation? Is this something that can be seen apart from that, Professor?
Well, of course, officially the two sides state that the South China Sea is not the sum total of their relations. No? So the official position is that this has no relationship to everything else. But I think for the ordinary person, it's clear that there is a link here. The fact that these activities are going on shows really that, in a way, it's actually in China's favor to compartmentalize these events, these issues, because they're able to continue undisturbed with their plans for these islands, despite everything else.
But the problem there is if the Philippines, if the national government buys into their script, their narrative.
Yes, in a way, the idea of compartmentalization really it's actually rather artificial, no? And maybe it would have worked before when the two parties, say for example in the 1990s, it was possible to compartmentalize because there was really no movement on the part of the two parties insofar as the these facilities and places that they were in control of. There was no change in the status quo. Mm-hmm. But now, with this, what we're seeing is that China is actually continuing to change the status quo every day. So the idea of compartmentalization of these two things really should not apply anymore.
So what can the Philippines do at this point?
Well, at this point, given that you now have a military base so close to Palawan, the only logical response will be to also beef up our defenses, no? Whether it will be in terms of strengthening our own military or engaging in closer alliances with other like-minded countries, no? Something needs to be done in order to address the destabilizing effect of this buildup. Because what's really happening is that in the course of building up their security and capabilities on Mischief Reef, the Philippines' own security suffers. No? We're the ones in a way, who are from whom the balance, in a way, for whom the balance is now being tilted, no? And it's being tilted against us, in a way.
There is no doubt in your mind that they are building a military base there.
No doubt about it. I mean, very clearly, even without expert analysis of these outposts, it's an airstrip designed for fighter aircraft. There are hangars, there are Coast Guard and Navy ships that are constantly using these places. And in the past 3 years, we've actually seen them used by China to interfere with the activities of other countries. No, so. We've monitored their Coast Guard ships using these bases as a way to extend their operations 24/7 deep in the South China Sea. We monitored their Navy always being there, and even their maritime militia is based there. So it's very clear that they are being used as military bases even now. The only difference, probably, the only thing lacking is really the fighter squadrons, no? But being actually permanently based there. But the ships are continuously there already. So these are definitely, these are military bases.
And why should the Philippines and the whole world care about China building their military bases in these man-made islands, Doctor?
Well, we know, of course, that China has an excessive claim to the almost the entire South China Sea, no? Extending as far down as Malaysian and Indonesian waters. The fact that they're building these military bases shows their intent to eventually take full control of this area for whatever reasons they might have, no? The most prominent one probably is there for their own security and defense. The problem is, while that is the right of every country to secure themselves, in so doing, they are undermining our own security and our own defenses, and all the surrounding countries, our neighbors, not the neighbors around us. So it comes at the cost of our security. And that's something that really should concern us in the region. And for the rest of the world, the issue there is that by doing so, China is also undermining the lifeblood of the global economy, which flows through this area, which is maritime trade. No, so the mobility of everything from cargo to even their own military vessels, their capability to move across this area, is the one that is threatened by China's increasing control of the South China Sea.
But yet here we are. There was a point before the first crystal of sand was put there to build these man-made islands, something could have intervened. But yet here we are, and we're talking about only one of the seven artificial islands that China has made. So at this point, Dr. Batong Bakal, what can be done, especially now that it's very obvious China's actions all point to one thing, that China exists for China alone?
Well, of course, the thing that can be done is to strengthen our alliances, because if we were to face China alone, then obviously that's a non-starter. They're so much bigger than us. And no matter what we do, given our limited area and resources, we can never really match the forces of China that will be deployed eventually in this area. So the obvious answer in order to make up for that is to build alliances and friendships with other countries that have the same or similar interests, no? And we do share interests with other countries in this regard. We should actually be continuing to strengthen those friendships and alliances in order to have a situation where China does not face only us, no? And we're not facing China alone, but we face China together with other friends and partners. That's the only way to equalize the disparity in power between us.
But under this administration, under this administration, do you see that happening?
Of course, right now I don't see that happening a lot. In fact, the problem I see is that there's a lot of inconsistency, in a way, because we see some quarters that are trying to strengthen friendships and alliances, trying to address the security challenge that is before us, but other quarters, especially the president himself, appearing to make statements that essentially could undermine that effort. So there's no consistency, as far as I can tell right now, at least in the public posturing and positioning of the government, even if there are attempts, no, probably in behind closed doors, to try to strengthen or at least maintain our security in this regard.
Okay.
So that is, I think, the bigger challenge. No, we have to have a concrete, consistent, and public posture here. No, and a position that very clearly portrays or demonstrates where we stand on things. If we are uncertain, or if we ourselves make ourselves appear to be uncertain, then it will be more difficult to create precisely the friendships and alliances that we need in order to protect ourselves from the challenge that this creates.
Dr. J. Batumbacal, Director of the UP Institute for Maritime Affairs and Law of the Sea from the University of the Philippines, thank you so much for joining us today. You keep safe, Doctor, and thanks again for being with us this afternoon.